Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing the Me Talk Pretty One Day book by David Sedaris. It was so good that it eased the torture of coach seats flying across country. It is easy to read in short intervals because it is composed of stories that can stand on their own. It has its sophomoric moments, but one thing that has developed in Sedaris' writing since his early days is generosity. Everyone shares similar experiences of failure and the sense of inadequacy, and Sedaris makes his incredibly funny, easy to read, and the short story format makes it a great choice for a quick read. Sedaris is definitely the funny man of this generation, and brings humor to everyday life as well as special occasions spanning cultures with a global grin. However, in his defense, that chapter was almost necessary to understand allusions in other of his stories. Reading the book, you feel like you are in a conversation with your best friend. Funny. Funny honesty written from a self-deprecating pop by a man who is out taking chances on life. This book is another one that you can dip into now, and again, and sample the varying products of Sedaris' offbeat sense of humor. A couple of chapters fell flat with a dull thud, but the majority of the book was quite entertaining. This book is not only funny, but insightful, and a bit delicate, in the subtle observations it makes about family, love, and the nature of the individual. Take a look, if you want to laugh and learn a little something about life. Couldn't get into the first part of the book, but the last 12 to 23s was funny and relatable. David's voice is unique and hilarious just in itself, and his voice comes through in the book as well. There were definitely some standout chapters, and the remaining chapters were pretty good in the book. The poignant, painful humor attached to reality allows the reader to examine multiple parts of reality at whatever level they may be able to tolerate. Me Talk Pretty One Day is at least as funny as Naked, and some of Sedaris' stories about living as an ignorant American in France were truly unforgettable. Sedaris is the P.G. Woodhouse of our era. It's not about plot twists and impossible fantasies, but regular people in slightly weird situations. Or smile like a fool when you read something that seems to have taken from your life too. There is a bit too much of his France and French adventures, but maybe others would relate to it better. The first portion of the book is Sedaris' autobiography of growing up in a quirky family, dealing with a not-too-successful speech therapist, and working as an artist, and in other trades. This is definitely a good book if you need some chuckles and some loud laughs. This book is very entertaining, but it's not as drop-dead funny as Sedaris' other work. The only thing better than reading this book is listening to it on CD as Sedaris himself reads from the pages. Sedaris' keen eye for comic detail pervades this collection of stories gleaned from his solo and family experiences in New York, South Carolina, and France. A good portion of them concern his move to France, although many focus on his family. Sedaris' storytelling style relies heavily on the humorous exaggeration, and for the most part it works. It does have some crude humor, as do most of his books, so keep it away from kids under 16. This is especially great to listen to on long road trips when you need more than music to get you through the drive. His take on life and the everyday happenings in his family are so wildly absurd, yet somehow believable, that you never want his books to end. If you haven't read some of the stories, it's extremely difficult to relay them in any decent manner. This condition of this book was not as advertised, however, it gets a pass because it is so funny. His family shines in all of their glorious flaws. His neurotic nature is endearing, and you can both relate and be happy that these things aren't happening to you. The only thing that might beat is as an audiobook read by Sedaris himself. Sedaris has a genius for describing the absurdities of life, and a real talent for forgetting himself in and out of very odd situations. His wit and writing style is a relaxing, entertaining, and immensely fun way to read through the antics of a life that's not so different from our own, but capitalizes on the humor a family uses to bind themselves together and to cherish one another. This book is inconsistent. The good parts are fabulous, and the ones that don't work. Once immersed in Sedaris' unique world, there is no escaping the humor of everyday encounters, situations, and observations. If you don't like or understand dry humor, or if you don't think or are not knowledgeable on a global level, you may overlook many of the funny moments. It's a very interesting read, but a bit hard to follow as it jumps in story a lot. His style of writing makes you feel like you know him, like has a friend sending you a letter updating you on the crazy events in his life. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.